I'm John R. Mack, John Robert Mack. I was a member of NFA from the time that I entered high school in 1955, which was in Bedford, Virginia. And that's how I became associated with NFA. There was an ag teacher there by the name of Sam Hughes, who had a tremendous influence on me as an individual with the NFA. So to make a long story short, I became the chapter president, which was there at the high school. And then later on, I became the federation president, which is a group of schools in the geographical area. And then from there, I was fortunate to become the Virginia State president. And that was in the 59, 60, 61 time frame. And after becoming state president, I continued in NFA and became the national president, where I served for one term. And NFA has opened up numerous doors, you know, for me, mainly in the from the standpoint of getting out and seeing how people are doing things, what other people are doing, getting a chance to travel and develop leadership qualities. Okay, I graduated from BSU in 1965, and my major was agribusiness. I was the first graduate in that particular discipline, agribusiness. When I came to Virginia State University, at the time it was called Virginia State College, and my plan was to major in ag education. I wanted to be an ag teacher, just like the teacher who had influenced me so greatly. But I had an opportunity from a company called Safeway Stores, which was a food chain, and at that particular time they were looking for minorities to go into management. And so they had a program wherein I could become a bagger at their local facility, which was here in Petersburg on West Washington Street. I became a bagger, and then upon graduation, I went to work for Safeway in the Human Resources Department. And it was an interesting time in my life in that that was kind of the first big city that I had been to spend any time, which is in Washington, D.C. And while there in the Human Resources Department, it was an opportunity for me to do some recruiting for the company at minority colleges. And so while on the recruiting trip, the opportunities were sounded so great, I ended up recruiting myself. I said, you know, I think I would be interested in working with Safeway in a different capacity than human resources. And at the time, the opportunity was in the dairy division or the supply division. And so I went into a training program with Safeway, spent a year in Washington, D.C., then went to Denver as a supervisor. And then from Denver, we went to California as a plant superintendent. And then from California, we moved to Utah as a plant manager. And from Utah, we came back to California to run the largest milk processing plant that the company had. And then from that point, I was able to continue to progress with the company, and I became a district manager. And I was in charge of five milk plants that the company was operating at that time. And then after serving in that capacity for a few years, I had an opportunity to come back east to Washington, D.C. to be the East Coast Dairy Operations Director, which I did until I retired 18 years ago.
That is life.
It was. It really was. It really was.
That's an NFA.
Okay. That's, as I mentioned earlier, when I became involved with NFA with my ag teacher. And there were many activities and contests that we had an opportunity to participate in. There were tool identification contests. There was public speaking contests and those kinds of things. So I had an opportunity to enter a the Federation Tool Identification Contest, which I won. And that was a thrill. I got a trophy and I got my picture in the local paper, and it was really a thrill. And then prior to becoming state president, I entered the state public speaking contest, and I won that also. And that was also quite an honor to win the state public speaking contest. And then from there, I continued to be involved. That's when I became the national president of NFA. Yeah, right. I had not had any contact with any of the people that I knew here at Virginia State, because I had moved around quite a bit, from the East Coast to the West Coast, back to the Midwest, back to the East Coast. And so, and when all of the moves, I kind of lost track of the people that I had known. I did manage to maintain contact with my ag teacher, who has since deceased, but we used to maintain contact. He always wanted to know, how are you doing, what are you doing? And so I used to keep him abreast of my progress, with Safeway, which he was very happy to hear and to acknowledge the fact that, it just takes good planning, good attitude, and be willing to do what's right. And that's that. I guess one thing that kind of sticks out in my mind is when I won the state president office. Prior to that, the New Homemakers of America had been meeting along with the New Farmers of America. Well, this particular year, for some reason, the New Homemakers of America did not come to Virginia State for their state meeting the same time that we did. So my campaign slogan was, vote for Mac and he'll bring the girls back. And that's what I did. And they came back the next year, and I was able to keep my campaign promise.
Love it. That's great.